I'm going to show you how simple and quick it is to add a custom watermark to your image in Lightroom. Hello, Kent Weekly here with another photography tip. Today I'm going to show you how to add a custom watermark or a logo to your image in Lightroom. It's a real simple process. Basically, what you're going to do is you're going to go to select the image you want to add the watermark to, and we're going to go to File, Export, and we're going to get the File Export dialog box. Now, I'm going to show you two things essentially here today. I'm going to show you how to export and size properly for a given purpose, and in the process, I'm going to show you how to add your watermark to this image. So we're going to go through the export dialog box, and I'm going to choose a destination. And for right now, I'm just going to add this to my desktop. And we'll keep this simple. There's no need to rename this. We're going to save it as a JPEG. We want this to go on a blog. And to make this more universally acceptable, we're going to use the sRGB format. And I'm going to downsize it a little bit. I'm going to bring it down to 60%. Now I know the particular blog size limit is 900 pixels wide, so I'm just going to limit this image size to 900 pixels wide and 900 pixels high. So now the height's really not affecting anything here, but I did limit the 900 pixels to the width. I'm going to add screen sharpening. That's going to make it just a little bit sharper for the web. And here's where we're going to add our watermark. But before we do that, we're going to go ahead and edit this. And you'll see here I have a variety of presets that I've already created. I'm going to go down to the very bottom. It says Edit Watermarks. Okay, when we first jump into this, you're going to see a text option. And typically it'll drop in your name here. And I've got the copyright symbol. Just to refresh your memory on that, the copyright symbol is Option G. Now, if you want to use just text and type your name, that's fine, not a problem. Let me show you the dialog box here so you're a little bit more familiar with how this is going to work. At the very bottom, there's an anchor point. This is going to give you the location for which you're going to start as far as the placement of your copyright. Right above that, you have the inset. You can move it up into the image however you like. You can also change your font. Oh, let's see here. We could do something a little different. Change the size of it here. Make it nice and big. You can change the opacity. Make it a little more subtle so it drops in there. However you'd like. It also has a drop shadow option here. You can play with that. So that's what you would do if you just want to use text. But you know what? We want to go beyond that. We want to make this a little bit more interesting. So let's use a graphic. Right off the bat, it's asking us for a graphic. Well, let me show you how to prepare a graphic. If you notice right up here, it says, please choose a PNG or JPEG file. Now, a PNG file is going to allow us to have a transparent background, and that's what we really want. So I'm going to show you how to set that up now. Let's go over to Photoshop. Now, I already have my logo set up here, and I have this set up in a couple different layers. I have a text layer, a couple different text layers, and a couple different fonts. Let me turn on the background so we can see this. Here's what I have. I have text layers with a drop shadow in it. Now to add that drop shadow, I simply went up, click the layer, go up to layer, and go to layer styles, drop shadow, and you're going to get all your parameters. Click on drop shadow, you're going to get all your parameters for setting up that drop shadow right there. Okay, so everything looks fine. I want this to be transparent on my photo. So what I'm going to do before I save this is I'm going to turn off the background layer. Turn that off, and you're going to see this checkerboard. Well, the checkerboard's not part of our graphic. It's Photoshop's way of telling us that this image is transparent, and we're looking at the background. Once we have that, I'm going to go to File, Save for Web and Devices. And this is going to give me the before and after. What I'm doing here is it's basically showing me this is my existing file in Photoshop, and this is the way it'll appear once it's saved. And again, we see these transparent backgrounds. If I change it to a JPEG, you're going to see the background go white. JPEG format does not allow for a transparent background, but a PNG file does. So I'm going to go to PNG-24, make sure transparency is checked, and I'm going to go ahead and save. And I'm going to save this to the desktop as well. Okay, now let's switch back over to Lightroom. Okay, so we were working with a text watermark here, but we want to change that to a graphic. As soon as we click on the graphic button up here, Lightroom's asking us, okay, what graphic do you want to use? Well, on the desktop, there's my logo. I'm going to choose that. Okay, and there it is. It's laid in the graphic. Now, again, I can change the proportion of this. I can change the opacity. It dropped in the settings that I had just previously used for the text version. I can make this 100%. I can bring it down. Okay, probably something along these lines. Probably going to bring it down a little bit. I don't typically like my watermarks being too bold. Obviously, the viewer should be looking at the image first. So we can make this a little more subtle. Drop it in there. Play with the inset. Bring it into the photo. Okay, now, when I save this, I can give this a preset name. So in other words, I can call this something very specific. And I'm going to let you know, too, this unfortunately, Lightroom does not show the previews of each of these presets very well. So it's a good idea to label this with a lot of information. So in other words, I'm going to put KW logo, white, and bottom right corner. So I know that if I use this, it's going to be my logo, it's white, and it's going to be the bottom right corner of the image. Go ahead and create. Now, I'm going to hit export, and remember, I told this to go out on the desktop. If we look up here, we can see the progress bar. It's exporting this image. Okay, it's done. Okay, so now if we go to our desktop, we can see that our image is sitting here. It's been saved. It's been reduced in size to fit the 900 pixel limit, and we have our watermark dropped in. It's that simple. Now this can be done when exporting one image, or it can be done exporting a number of images very quickly using the file export command in Lightroom.